Welcome to Zoology class. So in the last class, we have discussed about some aspects of transcription. That is the process of formation of RNA, especially messenger RNA, from a small segment of the DNA molecule or the transcription unit. So let us see once again, let us recapitulate what we have studied in the last class about transcription unit. So transcription unit consists of both the strands of the DNA molecule the template strand and the coding strand. Template strand and the coding strand. Template strand runs in the direction of 3' to 5', and the coding strand runs in the direction of 5' to 3'. Okay. And at the 3' end of the template strand or the 5' end of the coding strand, there is a promoter region. And at the 5' end of the template strand or 3' end of the coding strand, there is a terminator region. And in between these two regions, in between the promoter region and the terminator region, there is the structural gene. So it is the structural gene alone transcribes the messenger RNA or mRNA. Promoter region is required to initiate the polymerization of the RNA, because DNA dependent RNA polymerase enzyme requires this promoter region to initiate the polymerization, and the terminator region is required to end the polymerization reaction, polymerization of the messenger RNA. Okay. Now let us see, let us assume the base sequence of the template strand. Suppose the base sequence of the template strand is like this: guanine, cytosine, thymine, adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine, adenine, thymine. So this is the base sequence of the structural gene. Based on that, or complementary to this base sequence, an mRNA should be formed, should be polymerized by RNA polymerase enzyme. Okay. So here, what would be the base sequence of the mRNA formed here? So this is the mRNA, suppose this is the mRNA, and the base sequence of the mRNA here would be cytosine, guanine, adenine, and here this adenine, and it cannot be the thymine here because it is the RNA, and in RNA there is no thymine. Instead of that, it is uracil, and again uracil here, cytosine, guanine, adenine, uracil, adenine. So this is the base sequence of the mRNA formed. And this mRNA formed would be released from the nucleus. So this process is taking place in the nucleus, because DNA is in the nucleus. So the transcription takes place in the nucleus. of the eukaryotic cell. And in prokaryote, there is no definite nucleus and it takes place in the cytoplasm itself. Okay. And in the eukaryote, it takes place in the nucleus. And after the transcription, the mRNA is transported to the cytoplasm, where the next process, next step in the central dogma takes place, that is translation or protein synthesis. Okay. Now, we have seen in the previous classes that every phenotypic expression is produced by genes. And genes are located on the DNA molecule. Now, actually, what are these genes? It is difficult to define a gene. നമുക്ക് ജീനിനെ പല വിധത്തിൽ ഡിഫൈൻ ചെയ്യാൻ സാധിക്കും, പല രീതിയിൽ ജീനിനെ നമുക്ക് ഡിഫൈൻ ചെയ്യാൻ സാധിക്കും. നമ്മൾ അതൊന്നും ഇവിടെ ഇപ്പോൾ നമ്മൾ പറയുന്നില്ല. ഒരു ഡെഫിനിഷൻ പ്രകാരം അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു രീതിയിൽ നമുക്ക് ജീനിനെ നമുക്ക് ഡിഫൈൻ ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റുന്നത്, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് എ സെഗ്മെന്റ് ഓഫ് ദ ഡി എൻ എ മോളിക്യൂൾ ഫ്രം വിച്ച് ആൻ എം ആർ എൻ എ ഈസ് ഫോംഡ്. കാരണം എം ആർ എൻ എ ആണ് ഡി എൻ എയുടെ ഇൻഫർമേഷൻസ് കാരി ചെയ്യുന്നത്, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഡി എൻ എയിൽ അടങ്ങിയിരിക്കുന്ന കോഡഡ് ഇൻഫർമേഷൻ എം ആർ എൻ എയിലേക്കാണ് ട്രാൻസ്ഫർ ചെയ്യുന്നത് ബൈ ദ പ്രോസസ് ഓഫ് ട്രാൻസ്ക്രിപ്ഷൻ. ഈ എം ആർ എൻ എ സൈറ്റോപ്ലാസ്റ്റിൽ വരികയും ഈ ഇൻഫർമേഷൻ അനുസരിച്ച്, ഡി എൻ എ കൊടുത്ത ഈ ഇൻഫർമേഷൻസ് അനുസരിച്ച് എം ആർ എൻ എ സൈറ്റോപ്ലാസ്റ്റിൽ ഒരു പ്രോട്ടീൻ ഉണ്ടാക്കുന്നു, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ട്രാൻസ്ലേഷൻ ചെയ്യും. ആ പ്രോട്ടീൻ ഒരു എൻസൈമായിട്ട് ആക്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നു, ഒരു ബയോകെമിക്കൽ റിയാക്ഷൻ അത് കാറ്റലൈസ് ചെയ്യുന്നു, അപ്പോൾ ഒരു ഫീനോടിപ്പിക് എക്സ്പ്രഷനോ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു ചേഞ്ച് ഉണ്ടാകും. അപ്പോൾ അങ്ങനെ വരുമ്പോൾ ഫീനോടിപ്പിക് എക്സ്പ്രഷന് കാരണമാവുന്നത് ഈ സ്ട്രക്ചറൽ ജീൻ ആണ് എന്ന് നമുക്ക് പറയാൻ സാധിക്കും. അങ്ങനെയാണെങ്കിൽ അതിനെ നമുക്ക് ജീൻ എന്ന് വിളിക്കാം. നമ്മൾ അതിനെ സിസ്ട്രോൺ എന്നാണ് പറയുക. സോ സിസ്ട്രോൺ ഈസ് എ ജീൻ. സിസ്ട്രോൺ ക്യാൻ ആൾസോ ബി കോൾഡ് ആസ് എ ജീൻ, ക്യാൻ ആൾസോ ബി കൺസിഡേർഡ് ആസ് എ ജീൻ. നമ്മൾ അതിനെ സിസ്ട്രോൺ എന്ന് വിളിക്കും. സിസ്ട്രോൺ എന്ന വാക്കാണ് നമ്മൾ ഉപയോഗിക്കുന്നത്, സിസ്ട്രോൺ. സോ വാട്ട് ഈസ് സിസ്ട്രോൺ? വാട്ട് ഈസ് സിസ്ട്രോൺ? സിസ്ട്രോൺ ഈസ് ദ പോർഷൻ ഓഫ് ദ ഡി എൻ എ സ്ട്രാൻഡ്. Is the portion of a or segment of a DNA strand, a small segment of a DNA strand from which an mRNA is transcribed. അപ്പോൾ mRNA ട്രാൻസ്ക്രൈബ് ചെയ്യപ്പെടുന്ന ഒരു ചെറിയ റീജിയൻ, ഒരു ചെറിയ സെക്ഷൻ ആണ് നമ്മൾ എന്ത് വിളിക്കാം? സിസ്ട്രോൺ എന്ന് വിളിക്കാം. ഓക്കെ. ഇനി നമുക്കറിയാം ട്രാൻസ്ക്രിപ്ഷൻ ബോത്ത് ഇൻ പ്രോകാരിയോട്സ് ആൻഡ് യൂകാരിയോട്സ് ട്രാൻസ്ക്രിപ്ഷൻ ടേക്സ് പ്ലേസ് but with a certain differences. So prokaryotes ilum eukaryotes ilum ulla transcription le chila vyathasangal undu. So pradhanamayum rendu vyathasangalanu nanu kodukkanu, rendu vyathasangalanu pradhanamayittum transcription, prokaryotic transcription and eukaryotic transcription ullu. Endokkeyanu ee transcription le vyathasangal ennu namukku. What are the differences between eukaryotes and prokaryotes in terms of transcription? ഒന്നാമത്തെ ഡിഫറൻസ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്, ഫസ്റ്റ് ഡിഫറൻസ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്, ഇൻ പ്രോകാരിയോട്സ് in prokaryotes only one RNA polymerase is required, or only one RNA polymerase is present. that transcribes all the RNAs. So we had seen in the last class that there are three RNAs: mRNA, transfer RNA, and ribosomal RNA. All these three RNAs are required for protein synthesis or translation. And these all RNAs are transcribed by the single RNA polymerase. Single RNA polymerase. So, only one RNA polymerase, single RNA polymerase is present in prokaryotes. That is sufficient, that is enough for the polymerization of all the three RNAs. Whereas in eukaryotes, three RNA polymerases are present. Three RNA polymerases are present. Three RNA polymerases are present. Polymerase 1, polymerase 1, polymerase 2, and polymerase 3. Polymerase 1, polymerase 2, and polymerase 3. So these are the different polymerases, RNA polymerases present in eukaryotes with the different functions. With different functions. Polymerase 1 polymerases. It polymerases ribosomal RNAs. It polymerases ribosomal RNAs. Not all ribosomal RNAs. When we speak about ribosomal RNAs, there are different sizes, there are different types of ribosomal RNAs based on the sedimentation coefficient, based on the sedimentation rate. They are classified into various categories. So here, polymerase 1 polymerases 28S ribosomal RNA, 18S ribosomal RNA, and 5.8S ribosomal RNA. This S stands for the sedimentation rate of the, when it is centrifuged, the rate at which it is sedimented. So we have studied in last classes that you studied about cell biology or cytology. Okay. So polymerase 1 transcribes 28 or polymerases 28S rRNA, 18S rRNA, and 5.8S rRNA. Okay. Then polymerase second polymerases 8N RNA is the precursor of mRNA. This is the precursor of mRNA. That means HNRNA is first formed and it undergoes a processing. It undergoes post-transcriptional processing and becomes mRNA. So the first formed RNA is the HNRNA, that is called heterogeneous nuclear RNA. That would be converted to mRNA after some processing, that you will discuss shortly after. Okay. Then polymerase 3 polymerases transfer RNA, 5S rRNA, and SNRNAs. SNRNA means small nuclear RNAs. Small nuclear RNAs. So they are very much required for the processing of the heterogeneous nuclear RNA. I told you, the first formed RNA, first formed messenger RNA is heterogeneous nuclear RNA, and that should undergo certain processing, and then it becomes messenger RNA. SNRNA or small nuclear RNAs help in the processing of HNRNA. Okay. So, these are the three different polymerases, RNA polymerases in the case of eukaryotes. First, polymerase 1 transcribes, or it polymerases 28S, 18S and 5.8S rRNAs. Polymerase 2nd polymerases HNRNA, and polymerase 3 transcribes or polymerases transfer RNA, 5S rRNA and SN RNAs. So in case of eukaryotes, these three polymerases are required, whereas in prokaryotes, the single RNA polymerase performs all these functions. Okay, so this is the first difference. Now the second difference is, In prokaryotes, when the messenger RNA is formed from in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes from a cistron. I told you, the cistron, the structural gene of the transcription unit, or the transcription unit, is called the cistron. A cistron is the segment of the DNA molecule from where a messenger RNA is formed. That is called a cistron. So in prokaryotes, the mRNA formed is called, it is called polycistronic, whereas in eukaryotes it is monocistronic. So in prokaryotes the mRNA formed is polycistronic, whereas in eukaryotes the mRNA formed is monocistronic. Let us see what is the difference between polycistronic and monocistronic. Let us see what is the polycistronic mRNA. And to know what is a polycistronic and a monocistronic, we should know about certain other details of transcription. So in a template strand from where an mRNA is formed, suppose this is the template strand from which an mRNA is formed, let us write down the base sequence. Let us assume the base sequence like this: adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine, adenine, guanine, thymine, cytosine, thymine, adenine, guanine, cytosine, adenine. Okay, thymine. It is the base sequence in the template strand. Template strand. I am not writing the coding, drawing the coding strand here because it is not required here. Okay, this is a template strand from which, template strand of the structural gene alone. Okay, structural gene from which an mRNA is to be formed. Among these base sequences, in this base sequence, all the base sequences would not appear in the mRNA. There are sequences which are required and sequences which are not required. Certain sequences or certain base sequences are not required. And they should not appear in the mRNA. Such base sequences are called, base sequences which are required are called exons, and base sequences which are not required are called introns. Exons and introns. So exons are required base sequences. Introns are unwanted base sequences. They should not be present in the messenger RNA because they are unwanted sequences. They have no genetic consequence. Okay, so exons and introns. Let us mark the exons and introns here also. Suppose the up to here, this exon, and from here to here it is intron, and again from here to here exon, from here to here it is intron, and the rest exon. Okay, let it be like this. So when messenger RNA is formed in the case of a prokaryote, this is a prokaryote, only the exons would be transcribed into messenger RNA and introns would not be transcribed into messenger RNA. That means when messenger RNA is formed, only the exons are transcribed. That means this is the exon. So a messenger RNA formed here in this region. And the next intron region is, this is an unwanted sequence. Here messenger RNA would not be transcribed. And again, here again exon. This portion is the exon. And this exon would be transcribed into a messenger RNA. This intron that will be avoided because that is an unwanted sequence. And again exon, here messenger RNA would be transcribed. Now, three messenger RNAs are formed. Three messenger RNAs are formed here from three exons of the template strand. Okay. Now, according to the definition that we have given for a cistron is the segment of the DNA molecule from which a messenger RNA is formed. So here a messenger RNA is formed from this one, so this is a cistron. We can consider this as a cistron, and this is another cistron because a messenger RNA is formed from here, and this is another cistron because a messenger RNA is formed from here. So three cistrons are there. This one cistron, this another cistron, and this another cistron. Okay, even though they are part of the same transcription unit, same structural gene. Okay. Now, after the formation of mRNA like this, these pieces of mRNA will be joined together to form a single mRNA. So this is the final mRNA. This is the final mRNA formed. This is the final mRNA formed. So this is the final mRNA formed, and that mRNA formed from three segments of the mRNA formed from three different exons or cistrons. So we can say this mRNA is polycistronic because it has formed from many cistrons. Okay, It is formed from many cistrons. So that is why this mRNA in the use of prokaryotes is called polycistronic. Now this mRNA is ready for translation. And the mRNA form these introns. The sequence coming in the intron region have avoided. Intron has avoided. Okay. Only the base sequence of the exons are included in the mRNA. So that is why this is called a polycistronic mRNA. Now in the case of eukaryotes, this is not the case in the eukaryotes. In eukaryotes, even though in eukaryotes also exons and introns are there. Exons and introns are there in the eukaryotes also. But during the transcription, from the structural gene to a messenger RNA, introns are not avoided. Introns are not excluded. So, in the a messenger RNA is formed for the complete length of the structural gene. Including introns. So the base sequence, the complementary base sequence of introns also would be present in the messenger RNA. Okay. So that means only a single messenger RNA is formed here. So the structural gene, the whole length of the structural gene is a single cistron. Okay. It's a single cistron because only one messenger RNA is formed from here, formed from the structural gene. So, the entire length of the structural gene can be considered as a cistron. So, messenger RNA formed from only a single cistron. That is why it is called monocistronic. So, in eukaryotes, the mRNA form is called monocistronic. Actually, this is not called mRNA. It is called hnRNA. As I told you earlier, it is called hnRNA, heterogeneous nuclear RNA. Why it is called a heterogeneous nuclear RNA? It is not homogeneous, it is heterogeneous. Why? Because exons are there, introns are there in this mRNA formed, in this RNA formed also. Even though introns are base sequence, introns contain basic unwanted base sequence, these unwanted base sequences appear in this hnRNA also. Okay. Now, this hnRNA should undergo post-transcriptional changes. This post-transcriptional changes is not required in the case of prokaryotes. Why? What are post-transcription? There are three post-transcription changes that should take place in the case of eukaryotes. Let us see what are these post-transcriptional changes in the case of eukaryotes. So, post-transcriptional changes take place in hnRNA to convert this hnRNA into functional mRNA. So, hnRNA is not functional. It has to undergo post-transcriptional changes. Now, let us see what are the post-transcriptional changes. There are three post-transcriptional changes. One is splicing. One post-transcriptional change is called splicing. What is splicing? Why is splicing required in eukaryotes? Because of the presence of these introns. So splicing becomes necessity. Splicing becomes a necessity due to the presence of these introns in the hnRNA. Okay. And these introns should be removed from this HNR. So this is the intron in HNRNA, this region. And again, here intron is there. And this intron should be removed. Okay. So this part should be removed. This is unwanted. And again, this part should be removed because that is unwanted. Okay. In prokaryotes, this process is not required. The splicing is not required. Why? Because the messenger RNA formed already avoiding the introns that we have seen, that we have just now seen. But in prokaryotes, but in eukaryotes, the HNRNA formed includes the introns also. And later, and then by splicing, this intron should be removed. So, removal of introns from the HNRNA to include only the exons is called splicing. Okay, and after the splicing, the HNRNA, the formed HNRNA would contain only exons. The length of the HNRNA will be reduced because introns will be removed and only exons will be included in the HNRNA form, HNRNA after splicing. Now this is the HNRNA after splicing, which contains only the exons or wanted or required sequences. Okay. Now second post-transcriptional change is capping. Capping means at the 5 prime end of the HNR. So this is the 5 prime end and this is the 3 prime end. 5 prime end is considered as the head and 3 prime end is considered as the tail. Okay. So at the 5 prime end of the RNA, messenger RNA, heterogeneous nuclear RNA, an additional molecule is attached. That molecule is called methyl guanosine triphosphate. Methyl guanosine triphosphate. So this methyl guanosine triphosphate is added at the 5 prime end of the HNRNA. Suppose this is the methyl guanosine triphosphate. This is added at the 5 prime end. And this process is called capping. Then only it can be functional. Okay, this process is called capping. And third post transcriptional change is the tailing. Tailing. That is, at the 3 prime end, that is considered as the tail of the RNA, HNRNA, or messenger RNA. Here, a polyadenylate sequence is added. A polyadenylate sequence means repeated adenine sequence. Repeated to the extent of 200 to 300 base pairs. That means 200 to 300 adenine base pairs are added at the 3 prime end of the HNRNA. Now this has become a functional messenger RNA. Now this is called messenger RNA. It is now functional. So in eukaryotes, for the RNA transcribed from DNA should be functional, it should undergo the three post-transcriptional changes. One is the splicing, that is the removal of introns, and exons are joined together. Then capping, that is adding methyl guanosine triphosphate at the 5' end of the hnRNA. And the third one is tailing, that is adding repeated adenine sequences at the 3' end of the hnRNA. After these three post-transcriptional processes, hnRNA becomes functional, and now it is called messenger RNA. It carries a message. It carries informations regarding the amino acid sequence of a protein that should be synthesized in the cytoplasm. And after that, that will be released from the nucleus. After the post-transcription changes, mRNA would be released from the nucleus and sent to the cytoplasm for translation. Okay. So, these are the differences between prokaryotic transcription and eukaryotic transcription. Okay, let us see once again what are the differences in a quick look. First one is, in prokaryotes, only one RNA polymerase circuit is there that performs transcription of all the RNAs. And in eukaryotes, three separate RNA polymerase enzymes are there: RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2, and RNA polymerase 3. RNA polymerase 1 transcribes the 28S RNA, 18S RNA, and 5.8S RNA. Polymerase 2 transcribes the, or polymerizes the hnRNA, heterogeneous nuclear RNA, that is to become the mRNA after post-transcriptional changes. And then polymerase 3, RNA polymerase 3 transcribes transfer RNA, 5S rRNA, and small nuclear RNAs or snRNAs. That is the one difference between prokaryotic transcription and eukaryotic transcription. The second one is, in prokaryotes, post-transcriptional changes is not required. Splicing is not required. Capping or tailing are also not required. Because the mRNA formed itself is in the mRNA formed itself contain only exons. Introns are avoided at the transcription level itself. Okay. But in eukaryotes, post-transcriptional changes are required, like splicing, capping, and then tailing. Splicing, it is the hnRNA formed. It is hnRNA formed after the transcription, by the transcription in eukaryotes. That means the hnRNA formed contain both exons and introns. So the process of removing the introns is called splicing. And after splicing, at the 5' end of the hnRNA, a molecule, methyl guanosine triphosphate, should be attached. That is called capping. And at the tail end, or the 3' end, polyadenylate sequence ranges from 200 to 300 adenyl sequences are to be added at the 3' end. That is called tail. So after these three post-transcriptional changes, the hnRNA is converted to mRNA. That is the functional RNA ready for translation. It carries the coded information received from the DNA regarding the amino acid sequence of the would-be protein synthesized. Okay. So, that's about transcription. And in the coming classes, will be discussing about translation.